morning. And as Bill has just said, a key Paris terror suspect is still on the run tonight. And now his brother is urging Salah Abdeslam to turn himself in. Here he is.
Of course, my advice to him is to turn himself into the police. We are a family. We are thinking of him. We're wondering where he is. Is he afraid? Is he eating? The best would be for him to turn himself in so that justice can shed complete light. Because I am reminding you, Salah still hasn't been questioned by police, so he is still presumed innocent. Salah didn't neglect his obligations. He prayed.
Il ne manquait pas ses obligations. Il priait. Il ne buvait pas.
He prayed. He wasn't drinking. He would go to the mosque from time to time.
Il s'habillait.
He would wear normal clothes, jeans, a pullover, a jacket. Nothing that would make you think he was a radical.
Qui pourrait penser que c'est un radicaliste.
The fact that he was praying, that wasn't something that happened last week. He was doing that for a long time. A long time. Brahim and him were fasting. For us who lived with him, this wasn't what would make us think that he was radical or not.
The disbelief in that man's voice as well, as everybody tries to digest what's happened here. Fox News senior correspondent Rick Leventhal joins me now live from Paris with a bit more tonight on the search for these suspects. Rick, what have you found out?
Well, Martha, there's a lot of tension here in this city, and we've seen evidence of these aggressive searches by police looking for anyone connected to the terror plot or anyone connected to radical extremists. And we saw actually an arrest go down right in front of us, about 30 yards from our position here at Republic Square. We don't know if it was connected to the terror plot, obviously, but there certainly seemed to be a targeted stop. Heavily armed officers jumped out of their car and surrounded a vehicle that was stopped at a traffic light in front of them. They barked orders at the men inside, and two or three of those men then got out and were put face down on the pavement, and they were handcuffed, and they were hauled away. The whole thing was over in less than 5 minutes. There have actually been nearly 300 raids carried out across France over the past couple of nights, and we will see many more carried out tonight as well. More than 100 people have been detained as a result of those raids, and dozens of weapons seized, but still no sign of Salah Abdeslam, described as the eighth terrorist. The other seven, of course, were killed in the terror attacks. He's been described as the eighth terrorist, and now authorities say they're looking for at least one more, a ninth suspect directly involved in the terror attacks. But they haven't described that suspect. They haven't given us a name or a photo, only that they're looking for this man, Martha.
All right. Tell us a little bit about this stadium in Germany that was evacuated. What were the circumstances there, Rick?
It was a really unfortunate situation. In Hanover, Germany, there was this exhibition match, a friendly match between Germany and the Netherlands. The German chancellor was scheduled to attend because the government said it wanted to send a message that it wouldn't cow to terrorism and would stand up to terrorists. But then 90 minutes before that match was set to kick off, the stadium was evacuated and the game was canceled because of what the police chief called a credible threat, information about an explosion that was planned for inside the stadium. And a second stadium in Hanover, where a concert was scheduled, was also evacuated as a precaution, but no explosives were found at either venue and no arrests were made. Of course, these kinds of threats come into law enforcement every day around the world, and most of them turn out to be nothing, but the authorities have to gauge how credible these threats are. And certainly now in France and across Europe, they have to take everything a little more seriously, Martha.
No doubt. That's not the last time we're going to see something like that happen. Rick, thank you very much. So security forces hunting for more suspects tonight. It is an ongoing manhunt, and they are zeroing in a suburb outside of Brussels. And one area in Belgium that has been a long historic area that has links to terrorism and to misdeeds. Fox News Foreign Affairs correspondent Benjamin Hall now joins us this evening live from Brussels. Benjamin, what can you tell us about this community?
Well, Martha, as you say, the investigation has now moved here to Belgium, Brussels, and there is a massive manhunt underway just about a mile from here in that key area. There were dramatic scenes yesterday as police officers abseiled down some buildings to try and find those responsible for the Paris attack. released, but the two who were captured have now been charged with terrorist activities, and they were found to have explosive materials on them. Now, this Belgian connection is becoming ever clearer, ever stronger. We know that Saleh Abdeslam, one of the attackers, was able to escape here with two other accomplices, and those are the two who have been arrested, but he remains at large, and the police say he is both dangerous and armed, and the people should stay away from him. Also, from this city, from this neighborhood nearby us, is the suspected mastermind. He's another Belgian named Abdelhamid Abaoud. He has a long criminal history here. He's fought in Syria. He's bragged about killing infidels, and the police continue to search for him here. He has gone on to plan four major attacks over the last year, killing many, many people. He's been sentenced to 20 years in absentia, but he is still at large. And it is Belgium itself that is now under the spotlight. It is the highest percentage per capita of jihadis in Europe come from here who have gone to fight in Syria and Iraq. It's a country of 11 million people, but there are 600,000 Muslims here. They say that 800 have gone from Belgium to fight in Syria and Iraq, and most worryingly, 130 of those have come back. Now, that area nearby here that you mentioned is called Molenbeek, and it in particular is important. It's where the raids were carried out. There is a hotbed of jihadi sentiment there. We were there earlier. As we walked around, we could tell that this was dangerous, and the deputy mayor told us that there were secret prayer sites, secret mosques where people went to pray. We've also been told that the country has little control over that area. People we spoke there today said that they would not talk to us on camera because they were afraid that if they were seen talking to us, people would arrive, find them later with knives and even pistols. So yes, the areas around here have jihadi sentiments. They are protecting one another. And those people who are being hunted tonight are out there near us at the moment. Dangers ahead. Martha.
Very tense situation. Thank you very much, Benjamin.